Development Director.
He should be on the agenda.
Community Development Director.
It's a good winter so far.
Which means Gene has lost that side of her.
What? Hey, I don't wanna say that too loud, yeah, I'm gonna whisper it to.
Yes, yeah. Yeah, she's the assistant town manager. Okay, yeah, I got a couple minutes here. I thought I had my reading glasses in my pocket. I'm reading the paper at home. I took them out and put them on the table when I put my coat on.
I can't read.
I can read. No, I can. Sure, I don't mind if I'm fine. I can read. It's just a strain. That's it. Not a big deal.
I have a spare set of car too.
That's all right. That's what you do.
So in case I forget, I have
you end up going to these discount places, Christmas tree or something like that. You see them in a bin, three for a buck or three for five, and you go, well, I'll take three of those and leave them all over the place.
It works.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay, I have 7 o'clock. We'll call the January 7th, 2016 meeting of the Zoning Board of Appeals to order. We have one case on the agenda tonight, and that is case 1601, which is 57 Federal Street, and I assume that applicant is here.
Yes.
Let me go ahead and read the legal notice, and we'll take care of the preliminaries, and then you can make a presentation. The Zoning Board of Appeals will hold a public hearing in the Selectmen's Meeting Room at the Town Hall, 16 Lowell Street, Reading, Massachusetts, on Thursday, January 7th, 2016, at 7 p.m. on the petition of Anthony Cottarello, who seeks a variance and a special permit from sections 6.3 and 7.3.2 of the zoning bylaws, in order to request a special permit to expand the front porch 6.6 feet by 11.6 feet with platform and stairs, and to expand the rear for a two-story addition, and to request a variance to add a single-story detached two-car garage 24 feet by 25 feet at the rear of the property located at 57 Federal Street in Reading, Massachusetts. The lot coverage will be 28% rather than the required 25%. Unless there is an objection, I will dispense with the reading of the abutters list, except to say that the abutters were notified, as were the following: Board of Selectmen, Town Clerk, Police Department, Fire Department, Building Department, Conservation Commission, Health Department, Assessor's Office, Engineering Division, CPDC, members and associate members of the Board of Appeals, as well as the planning boards of Wakefield, Linfield, North Reading, Stoneham, Woburn, and Wilmington. Testimony given before the board is taken under oath, so if you think you may want to speak tonight, please stand and raise your right hand, and I'll swear you in. So anybody who feels they may want to speak or comment on this, I'll swear you in, no problem. I swear that the testimony given by me before this board will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. Response is I do.
I do.
Okay. Nancy, if you would like to?
Mr. Redfern, before we engage in testimony from the applicant, I'd like to put it on the record that Ms. Toomey and I serve on another board committee in town, just so that that's out in the open.
Okay.
I don't feel that that poses a problem with regard to my objectivity relating to the case at bar. And I thought I also put it on the record.
Fine. If anybody has, would like to question David on that, I don't have an issue. Okay, thank you. Thank you, David.
Thank you. My name is Nancy Toomey. I am the architect helping Tony Catalullo, who is the owner of the property. What we are seeking is, as was mentioned in the reading, a variance from 6.3 for lot coverage and a special permit for non-conforming structures at 7.3.2. The house, actually just to say, Tony is a police officer here in town. His family, which is here, has grown up in this house. It's been in the family for quite some time. Tony lives in another home here in Reading, but he's planning on moving to this property. And he wants to, the goal is to renovate it so that it's comfortable for him to live there. We have, in order to add a bathroom to the second floor, right now it's two bedrooms and no bathroom, we need to expand the second floor, and there is a small addition, two small additions actually out the back, but unfortunately they don't have adequate foundations. So we're in the situation of having to remove basically the back part of that existing house, put in new foundations, and raise it. The non-conforming of the structure really comes to the porch on the side. It's in bad shape. He wants to obviously replace it and fix it, and we want to expand it to fit the side line so that the entire structure is covered with a new roof. So that's the special permit, and non-conforming is on that side. We are also at the back as we expand back, because it's such a small piece of property. When we do that expansion, we're going to be following the lot line, not getting any closer, but we are going to be needing a special permit in order to be able to put back essentially what's there, plus a little bit more. So that's the special permit part of it. Probably the one that's a little more difficult to really grasp is the variance aspect of this property. I've included in the packet that I gave you a copy of the GIS maps to show, and also you have the tax maps in addition, but to show the structures in that neighborhood. This is Federal Street, Locust Street, Highland Street. These properties were developed well before zoning came into effect in Reading. And this particular property is one of the narrowest and smallest in those neighborhoods. It's 6,250 square feet, which is less than half of the S15 district that it's located in. The new bylaw that was passed last year included a new provision, or I guess it was a definition, and frankly, I missed it when it went through, otherwise I would have had something to say about it at the time, for these small little properties in particular. But it now includes in the definition for lot coverage any detached structure, any accessory structure on a piece of property. And in a standard S15 lot, 50,000 square foot lot, that's pretty easy to get on a 25% lot coverage. But when you start to look at these tiny lots that we have in Reading, it puts them in a bind. They cannot add on a two-car garage or any substantial deck or anything to the back of these homes, a pool, anything that other lots in the district can by right enjoy because they have a little bit bigger lot size to them. So the variance that we're asking for is simply Tony has a truck, a car, motorcycle. He needs a workbench to be able to work on these cars. We're looking for a reasonably sized two-car garage, 24 by 25, in order to be able to get two cars, a motorcycle, and a workbench into that structure to protect it. And one of the things about this particular lot is that it's long, even though it's narrow, it's very long, and we can fit that two-car garage at the back, still conforming to the five-foot setback, still conforming to the single story, which is also part of the new bylaws, and still conform to the 600 square foot maximum for a detached structure. What we can't seem to be able to do is get it to fit within the 25% lot coverage on a very small lot. So our request to you is to ask for a variance. We're looking for, it's 28%, it's about 182 square feet over, if you wanted to do the calculations, which is in garage size, it would be about 7 or 8 feet off of that 24-foot length. So it wouldn't be a two-car garage, no matter how we figured it out. You could get an oversized single-car garage, but not a two-car garage. We feel that this is a hardship, a financial hardship, because he cannot enjoy his lot as others can in the neighborhood and have been able to do. I think this neighborhood is quite dense. I have not done any calculations for any of the properties there, so I can't tell you one way or another what everybody else is, but just a brief look at that GIS map tells me, if you include on some of these smaller lots with the pools, that they're going to be pretty close, if not over, to that lot coverage limit that we've now set on these small properties. I truly don't believe this is a detriment to the neighborhood. His lot also slopes pretty significantly towards the back. So on one of the elevations, I also included of the drawings that we've produced, it's the front elevation. I think it's sheet 7. It kind of shows you the relationship of the main house to where that garage is, to the front of the house. So it's very low. There are detached structures in the neighboring properties next to it. So I don't believe that this is really going to cause any issues with the neighborhood and how it looks. Yes, sheet number 7. I've ghosted in the location of the garage doors to what the front of the house looks like at the street. So we're certainly not adding an overpowering garage to this property. I don't know if there's any questions that you may have. Happy to entertain them.
Okay. Thank you. At this particular time, we did get a memo from the building inspector sent to us, and I will read that into the minutes here, and it's his comments. ZBA chairman, regarding case number 16-01, the proposal to add a front porch, a rear addition, and deck, and to construct a freestanding garage exceeds the allowed lot coverage of 25%, as the applicant has just stated. A variance from section 6.3 would be required for the lot coverage and for the side yard setback of the proposed 4x4 platform. In addition, your proposal to add, your being the applicant, a front roofed porch in the rear addition and deck does not comply with the required front setback, 20 feet, and the required side yard setback, 15 feet. A special permit from section 7.3 and 7.3.2 would be required. Thank you, Glenn Redman, Town of Reading Zoning Officer. David, we'll start with you. Any comments, questions to the applicant?
I do, but before we get started, I'd like to ask the board how we think we want to proceed with this. Do we want to proceed on a special permit analysis first, or do we want to proceed considering variance first? I'd like to defer to the chair as to how we'd like to perhaps go at this.
Rather than my personal opinion is, I think we can attack it all at once.
Okay.
and discuss everything at once.
Okay.
And then when we make a motion, we will have to make separate motions then on those particular items.
Okay.
But I think rather than go around and to discuss a variance, then go around again and discuss a special permit, then go around again and a variance on the door, let's see if we can discuss
okay.
everything at once.
All right. Yeah. I wanted to get your input on that.
Sure.
So as I see the application, we have a special permit for a front porch and an expansion of the rear. That's what the special permit's for, correct? And then a variance relating to the single-story detached garage. Okay. I'm gonna start with the variance criteria, and you went briefly through, Nancy, some of the four criteria. And I know you've probably perhaps forgotten more about this than we may ever know. But I did a little bit of, I've done a little bit of research, and I know enough about this from my own land use practice. And there is pretty specific case law in Massachusetts relating to the variance aspect of this case. And that an undersized lot cannot be grounds for granting of a variance. That doesn't make the lot peculiar in shape, size, or topography. Secondly, the hardship criteria, I think, goes more to the how the law looks at it as, you know, the theoretical potential of the land being underserved if a variance weren't granted, and that again is not a criteria for a granting of a variance. Could you address those aspects of the applicant's petition, please?
Yeah, I would say that it's one of those issues that makes it very difficult, clearly, to get a variance in a town once bylaws have changed to make things much more difficult. And every town looks at it very differently, I will say. I would agree with you that the topography of this land is not necessarily any different than the rest of the land that's in that area. There isn't a huge drop-off. It doesn't, you know, make it difficult to use that property. I do think that that it's a situation of where the rest of the developed area in that location is quite dense. So it's difficult to see, you know, it just puts him in a difficult position right now, because now all of a sudden he can't use his land as everyone else has enjoyed in the past and will be able to enjoy to some extent in the future. So, you know, that, I think the hardship part of it is probably more related to that aspect of it. I think that he can't use the land the way most in the neighborhood have been able to use and will be able to use. The smaller lots already are using. So that's really where the hardship is coming, not the topography, shape of the lot.
All right. As far as the special permit aspect of it, we're merely expanding an existing front porch.
Correct. Yes.
And you know, I guess I should look a little closer at the drawings. When you say a platform and stairs.
Yeah, what that is, and that is Glenn's.
Yeah.
We've gone back and forth on this.
I know.
Yeah. So in this particular case, that platform is actually the second step down. In order to be able to get the steps to keep them from coming straight out, which we could do, and he'd end up in the neighborhood, the neighbor's yard.
Right.
The intent is to have a step down and then continual steps. I view this platform as part of the steps. It's a landing and steps down. I don't view it as being an addition to the porch.
Okay. I think the town views the platform as not included in the encroachment into the front setback.
Right.
And so, without putting words into your mouth, it sounds like you're perhaps waiving that and including, because it's now part of a step,
that will
be included in the encroachment?
That's correct.
Okay.
Yeah, that's
just
correct.
Because
you
it's more aesthetically
it
and
yes,
utilitarian.
Exactly.
Okay.
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
Yeah, safer. Yeah.
Let's see. The expansion of the rear for the two-story addition.
Yes.
That is not going to be encroaching any further into the setback?
That's correct. We've stepped it back 5 inches, or 6 inches essentially, so that at the very back, The proposed is 11.9. Currently, it's 11.6.
Okay.
So we're pushing it back a few inches in order to make sure that it doesn't encroach.
Okay.
And that seemed to be the simplest way of getting that foundation in, getting a reasonable size for this addition.
That makes, yeah,
yeah.
Makes sense. That's all I have for now. Thank
yeah,
you.
Thank you.
That's okay.
Yep,
okay.
That's all I have for now. Thanks.
John.
I just had a couple of questions. I'm still digesting some of this. You said that the excess of the 25% coverage was approximately 180 square feet.
That's correct, 182 square feet, correct.
And on the enclosed or the extension of the proposed roof area, that platform, that's going to be enclosed.
The platform for the steps is not enclosed, but the proposed roofed porch. There's a small porch there now, and what we're asking is to make it wider so that it goes all the way across that little jog of the house. There's a, if you look at it, that little X'd red section on the porch, that's what we're talking about with that proposed porch. These are just simply stairs to go to the backyard off of that porch. Right now there are concrete or flagstone steps.
Right.
That whole porch is concrete with flagstone and it's falling apart. So we need to demolish that, and in the process of demolishing it, putting in proper foundations, and it made sense to make it a few inches larger. So we're talking about, I think, about 6 inches or so, maybe a foot across.
Just to the edge of the house.
Yeah, the edge of the existing house.
And just to clean it up and just a little, I think it's about 6 to 12 inches.
Yeah, somewhere in there.
It's not that much of a.
But it's not a porch, it's just a landing, basically. That's how you get into the door.
House, yeah, but it has a roof on it, so it's considered a porch.
But it appears also that you have two sets of stairs for that.
Yes, there's stairs coming towards the front where the street is, and that's the main entrance. So I think in the past there are an enclosed sort of a winterized front porch, mm-hmm. and that used to be the main entrance, and there are steps that are actually quite hazardous right practically on the sidewalk going up to the door that goes into that porch. That's going to be eliminated. They're eliminating that door, eliminating those stairs. The primary entrance is going to be off of this new fixed porch.
Well, it doesn't show it on here, so I was trying to figure out.
Yeah, I know, it's hard on the site plan. If you look, you know, probably, if you look at my drawings, it might be a little easier to see.
Yeah.
If you look at sheet one, if you have those, the first floor plan existing, you can see the names. So this enclosed porch was the main entrance at one point, and this was just a side porch that went straight into the kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
We're maintaining that side porch, but instead of it being short as it is, it's going to be as wide as that section, so that you come up on that open porch and you go in. So it's almost like a farmer's porch, but it's facing the neighbors instead of the front. This front door will be closed so that, because nobody goes into it now anyway, and the stairs are hazardous, they'll be eliminated. So the main entrance will be into the kitchen, and there will be a rear exit, because we need two exits out of every house. The rear exit out of the new back den space will go to that small deck, and that deck will go down to the backyard where the driveway is. Okay, so if you look at sheet number, I think it's 3 or 4, I can't remember. Sheet number 4, you'll see the progression, so.
Okay, so what on sheet 1 is bedroom 3 is now going to be a den?
That's correct.
Got it. Okay,
yeah,
got it.
That's
yep.
the den.
Right.
Yep, and there's sliding glass doors that will go out really to a very small deck, which is meant to get out of the house and get down to the driveway.
Yes. How about pass for right now, I still have a couple of questions, but I'll, let me pass for right now.
Sure. Sorry, any questions?
Just so it's clear to me again, you got those front steps going currently into the current enclosed porch?
Yes, and there are.
And then there's a little walkway that goes from the front of those steps to the side and into the.
Yes.
Side steps that go into the.
Yeah, I know.
The one you want to expand, okay?
Exactly.
Okay.
So there's little steps that come off the.
Right.
And then there's, this is really a larger walkway.
Do I understand that you say that you're not going to use that, you're not going to enter that front enclosed porch anymore?
That's correct.
Are you going to take those, are you going to take those steps out?
Correct. Yeah, those steps go and that door goes. Yeah, they're a hazard more than usable.
Okay. I was confused when you kept. The application keeps referring to the front porch.
Yes,
it's really a side porch.
Yeah, it's really, it should be the side porch.
Side porch with front steps.
With front steps, yes.
And then looking at what you want to do on the side.
Yeah.
It looks as though you're encroaching on the setback less with what you're adding than you are with what you have.
You've got it. That's exactly right, by a few inches.
So the encroachment is less.
It's much less on the back, and that's because we're taking.
It's a little bit less.
Not much less, yeah, 2 inches.
Yeah, right, you got it.
Yes.
Okay. So, no, that would suggest to me that it's a good way to go. So the way I see it, the only thing we're talking about here is a variance on the.
Well, I think, Si, and it's, correct me if I'm wrong, Nancy, the building inspector's contention that because they're putting in a 4x4 foot landing that was not there before, he considers that a structure.
Mm-hmm.
And so consequently, you're going to need a variance on it, whereas before it was just stairs there.
Correct.
And those weren't considered a structure.
But
I would agree with you. To me,
but the only thing they asked for was a variance on.
Lot coverage.
No, I think they asked for the variance on the steps too.
It's advertised. It's advertised for the variance.
Yes. Yeah. It was advertised that way.
Well, in the application, I know, maybe it's in the application.
Yeah, the application.
With the platform and stage.
Yeah, I was looking at the application.
Yes.
The application only asked for lot coverage.
That's correct, Glenn took the position that 4x4 platform is not considered a step.
Right. All right. I don't have any further questions.
I would, Okay. Eric?
Both the special permit, if we're going to bifurcate it that way, I think. Makes a lot of sense. I don't see any real issues with that, except for, I guess, how we're going to interpret that platform. And I don't know if that's something that the board can come to a consensus on. I think my vote is that if it's a step down, I guess I could definitely see myself calling that a step, or I'm sorry, a step in the absence of any authority to the contrary. And then I wouldn't have a major objection to the special permit. And then, of course, you know, we are all kind of deferring on the variance for the lot. I guess the tough part with that is that the garage by its nature is an accessory use. So the hardship portion of it, at least for me right now, I think definitely, you know, warrants some discussion. Obviously, you could get a one-car garage or an oversized one-car. We're only looking at, you know, 182 feet. And I guess that's kind of how I see the situation.
Okay, thank you. I kind of feel the same way. Questions that I had on it. And I don't have any real issues with the request for the special permit. Personally, I look at the 4x4 platform. Now, is that a step down from
step
the porch?
Down. Yes,
so
correct.
It's not level with that.
No.
Yeah, so it is a step down. Though the building inspector is the one that issues the building permit, etc. I don't want to get in a, you know, argument on them. He looks at it as a structure, so I would have to say we'd either have to make a finding in this particular case that the board looks at that and decides it's a step and not a structure, a 4x4 structure, but an integral part of the steps, or we issue a variance on that 4x4. I don't have an issue either way. To me, it's fine. It's less encroachment, as I points out, than what was there now in regards to this, the existing stairs in that side yard. I don't have an issue on that. So I could go either way on that, either a variance or, well, I think if we did do a special permit for those side steps, we'd have to make a finding, since the building inspector has noted that a variance would be required on that because he considers it a structure. What I do have an issue with is the garage. And I've heard the arguments. You read the criteria there, and it's circumstances related to the soil condition, slope, topography, especially after affect the land or the structure, et cetera, et cetera. I don't consider the lot itself unique in that there is a lot of lots in that area or in that neighborhood of similar dimensions. And I took a ride in that down their street, took a look at some of the properties. And also, I couldn't see behind them, but looking at the GIS map, it appears that a lot of the properties don't necessarily have double garages. They may have single garages, which certainly he could build without a variance on that, no problem. Second criteria in the variance talks about a hardship. I think the key word there is the question would involve a substantial hardship. It may be a hardship, he considers it a hardship, but I think it is nothing substantial on that. It's not earth-shattering on that. I live on a small lot myself. I would, you know, nice double garage would be nice, but I could never fit one in, and, you know, you just have to live with it. That's what you have. I think if you fooled around with the dimensions there, yeah, you might put in a small double garage in there. It would be tight, but you might be able to do it. Or an oversized single garage would fit. I kind of agree with the board in that aspect. Now, correct me, this is, looking at the plans here, an existing three-bedroom right now.
Correct.
There's a bedroom on the first floor, two on the second floor.
Correct.
It's being converted now, when all the construction is done, one bedroom?
Two bedrooms, just two on the second floor. Correct.
Two on the second floor. I saw the second floor plan. I only saw a bedroom.
There's a bedroom at the front, correct? Yeah.
Let's see. You can do what you like.
Yeah, that's exactly
just
right.
Your question.
That's right. This is what he's asked for.
Yeah.
His second floor plan has a bedroom.
Bedroom one.
Oh, it's called an office. You're correct.
And then an office. Yeah.
And then it's bedroom one,
so
large
it's just,
bedroom. Yeah, that's
yeah.
What his plans are. The office
yeah.
is truly a.
That's fine. Yeah. So it's just it's so, yeah. We don't get that too often. Converting a three bedroom to a one bedroom, but. Okay, I just wanted to kind of clear up. And on the garage now, there will be an attic in that. That's no use to, no plan to use that at all up there.
Just
might be used as
storage
or something.
Correct.
Yeah. Because it does have a gable.
It has
yeah.
a gable,
yeah. Yeah.
But it doesn't have access to it in terms of making it anything other
yeah.
than a pull downstairs. So, yeah.
Okay. And I take it that the applicant. And that's what I was going through here. He inherited this property. The application, it's he
yeah.
signed it as the owner, right?
Well, my parents passed away. It's in a trust.
Right.
And it's my sister's. And my intention is to, I'm converting it. I'm gonna buy them out.
He's gonna buy it.
And I am going to move from Reading, a house in Reading, to Federal Street. That's my intention. That's why I'm here to remodel it and especially with the deck, the side deck, and the garage and so forth. And that's where I grew up, that's why I want to go back.
Mm-hmm.
I'm comfortable there. The neighbors are great there. I just, the whole thing is
Works for you, sure.
It's
yeah, I was just questioning because I saw, you know, right. It's owned by a realty trust or a trust.
Not a relative
but
trust.
Yet, it's a trust,
yeah.
Yes.
And, you know, the board doesn't like to get in the middle of a fight between siblings
oh, no.
or something like
no,
that.
That's what I get all. And I have all the documents here from Latham.
Okay.
You need to see them.
That's fine.
There's no issue at all. We're all on the same page.
We're
and
not
I,
usual.
Yeah.
Sure.
And I get my the closest neighbor behind me. Who,
they're right next door.
I think that would affect them the most. And the Kellys, and they're all for me moving.
Sure.
Moving back home and constructing the garage.
Could I speak in Tony's behalf?
Okay. Why don't I then on right now? I'll open this up for public comment.
We'll open up the sworn in.
John.
That's what I do.
Okay. We'll get back. Some of the board members will have further questions,
okay.
But since somebody was ready to speak, I thought I'd open it up for comment. Yes. If you could identify yourself and your address. This is for the minute. Yeah.
I'm David Kelly. This is my wife, Pam, and we live at 59 Federal. You're standing in the street looking at Tony's property, which to the left. And we're pleased to see Tony taking the old homestead and renovating it, and he'll be a welcome member back into the neighborhood. But if I could speak on his hopes to be able to build a two-car garage.
Mm-hmm.
Known Tony, well, we, Pam and I have lived there for 35 years. I've known Tony that long. He enjoys motor vehicles and his motorcycles, and he takes a lot of pride and care for them. So if I were able still, I would enjoy the same hobby. But I completely understand why he'd want the two-car garage to have a small workshop out there. He has a very nice pickup truck, a very nice automobile, which he cares for meticulously, as he does his property. But his request to be over on the square foot coverage of the lot by just a small amount to facilitate constructing the two-car garage seems to me to be more than reasonable as a request. Again, we're right next door, and we're right on top of each other the way that neighborhood is built. And neither Pam nor myself have any issue with him wanting to put up that garage in the back portion of the property. I'm sure it will be done tastefully and cared for tastefully. And everything Tony has done in his previous, you know, the home he lives in right now, it's all first class, it's perfect. It's perfectly cared for, and anything he builds at 57 Federal Street will only be an improvement to the neighborhood. In fact, it might most likely be, except for my house, the nicest house on the street.
Thanks, Dave.
Okay, thank you. Is there anybody that would have any other comments in regards to this? Feel free to speak if you would like to. Okay.
If I could just say one
thing. Sure.
You know, I'm not against, I would like a two-car garage side by side, but I'm not against possibly if you don't feel that acceptable, two-car garage, maybe a car that, a garage that's end-to-end type, a little longer, or some sort of a structure that's more, like a park. Two cars end to end. I don't know if that would work. I don't know if that would suffice. I would speak to Nancy about that
sure.
fact, and that we could see if that would work. But that
right.
I'm open to opinions anyway.
Right. Right.
But I don't want to be. I want to be. Cooperative, but I don't want
right.
whatever you guys think.
Okay, thank you. Anybody else like to speak? If not, I will close the public portion.
What?
Who's in charge?
I have questions, now you're forced to.
Oh, well, that's for the, you can ask the public. I'll reopen the public portion, John, if you had a question, go ahead.
I have two. First one, I'm asking Nancy as well as the owner, so I don't know who I'm, you know.
Throw it out.
Anyways.
I think you need the public for that.
Throw it out, yeah.
Okay. I'll start with the 4x4 platform. Right now you have basically two staircases going through to the entrance. By eliminating the platform, all you're doing is using a extension of that porch, enclosed porched area, or roofed, I shouldn't say enclosed, roofed area. And if you put the lattice up again, that's not enclosed, I don't think. But the intention would be that you remove one issue that is coming before the board.
Yeah, what I would offer to you is this, that I think from, if the platform is a difficulty in terms of making it into a variance, if I made it a winder, it's clearly a stair. So I think Tony's intention is to be able to come out of the kitchen, turn, and go straight to the back. Because that gets him down, if that lot has that slope, he's got a little garden on that side. It gets him out to that garden and then down to the backyard without having to go out the back door, down the deck, or out the front and around. So that's the intention of those stairs. And I think if the variance is an issue, which, I mean, I understand that 100%, I think what I would do is put a winder, so there'd be a divider to make it clearly a staircase going down. Do you see what I'm saying? So, because it's better for us to turn it than it is to go into the neighbor's yard.
Right.
Right. So if that becomes an issue, we'll make it a true stair. And stairs are exempt from the setback. So I will work with Glenn to make it a stair.
Personally, I don't know where the building inspector is coming from, because we've dealt with these before.
Well,
front steps always have a landing.
Building code.
Okay.
So you can turn around and maneuver,
yes,
etc.
But I think where Glenn is coming, I'm just
okay
guessing.
Yes.
We have a platform there that we're covering. That, in essence, is a stoop.
I'm
it's
not
an accelerated,
covering it.
It's an extended stoop, per se. A 4x4 is reasonable as far as the state building code, and always with Glenn.
Yeah.
But you're asking for a stoop on top of the platform that's there that you're going to enclose with the roof.
No, it doesn't have a roof on that particular portion. That has
no
roof.
No. I know that.
No.
Okay.
But you have. Well, you're going to tear out the foundation.
Yes.
And replace it.
Yes.
Correct.
Correct.
That becomes a stoop, in essence, an extension of an extended stoop, because
right,
it's going to be what? It's going to be 6x6 by 11x6.
That's right.
And then
it's,
you're putting a stoop on top of that for the staircase. That's where he's coming. I'll bet you he's coming.
I bet that's probably what he's thinking, is that now it's another,
correct,
another porch down. But it's
turn
it's,
the stairs.
Yeah.
Turn the stairs. Make the stairs come up right onto that refounded,
right,
area.
But it
does not become an issue anymore.
But there's a door there, is there not?
No,
I mean,
so I think
that's being enclosed with a roof over it. That's
and
becoming
that's
part of the house.
It's just going to have a roof. It's not being enclosed.
Oh,
it's not enclosed. No, it's just another porch.
Enclosed.
Okay.
So it's porch.
It's
so he's.
I see.
It's open.
So
I see. I think you're right.
We've dealt with that with Cupola's applications.
Okay.
Well.
Yeah, I can see. I mean, he's.
Yeah.
My interpretation is that when you're stepping down and making a turn, it's easy to. I mean, in a staircase. Typical staircase, you go down a couple of steps and
right,
then you turn on a landing. I see it more as a stair landing. And I think if we were to just put a winder in it so that I can get it to be a step, and then more steps.
And it doesn't have to be right at the corner either. You can move it forward a little bit.
Yeah, I think structurally it's a little easier to build it straight off of that edge. That's really what it is. It comes down.
I'm not an architect, so I won't tell you what to do. I'm just looking at
perhaps
solutions for this.
So it's basically that's it's gonna have a roof over it, but there'll be posts supporting the roof, and it's not enclosed.
That's correct. It's like a farmer's porch on the side, or a side porch, a true side porch to these side colonials, yes, correct.
But not the platform.
Yeah.
I'm thinking, you're going up, it's a door, it's all, you know, it's part of the structure, you gotta stand at the door and unlock it.
I see what you're saying, yes.
You have groceries in your hand or whatever.
Right, that would be a different, yes, than I would be arguing. But no, this is just part of that stair system.
That's, I'm trying to come up with some solutions.
Yeah.
So that would be solution number one. It takes it out of our purview.
Yeah, you don't need.
We wouldn't need anything. We'll figure out a way to make that a stair, and I know we can make that work. I thought that by stepping down one step, we had done that, but obviously he took an exception to it.
Okay, that's number one.
Yeah.
Number two, we're short about 182 square feet in terms of 25%. If you look at the garage that's proposed, it's 24 by 25.
Correct.
My question is, why 24 by 25? A normal garage, two-car garage, is 20 by 24.
24 by 24 is a typical two-car garage for today's standards. Part of the problem we have is that the cars, the mirrors on the side of those cars are so wide that you really need a 9-foot door in order to be able to get access in, especially with two cars, or at least a 16-foot door for a two, you know, one large opening to a two-car garage. So for today's standards, 24 by 24 is pretty much the best size. 22 by 22, you could kind of do it. But even if you think about that 182 square feet, that's still not a two-car garage. You're taking out a good third of that 24 by 25. The 24 by 25 comes from the bylaws. It says that you're allowed to have a detached structure as large as 600 square feet. That's 24 by 25. Mm. So we started with that number.
Yeah.
I mean, if we're gonna come before you, we wanted to be able to come before you with something that we knew would meet the bylaws and would be comfortable for Tony's use with a workbench, a motorcycle at the back, and then two cars inside. Clearly, if this is something that is gonna be an issue, we'll rethink. That's what we will do. But that's where the 600 square feet, the 24 by 25. 20 by 20, by today's standards, it's very difficult to get two cars in a 20 by 20 garage.
That's about what you could get
SUVs.
In, yeah.
Yeah.
Two SUVs.
A 21 by
yeah.
20 or something. You,
yeah.
That it's, would just about fit.
Yeah, the cars themselves, you figure, not a truck, but my car, which is a CRV, is, I think it's, when I measured it last, it was like 14, 15 feet, 16 feet.
Mm.
So on a 20-foot garage, you're losing a foot because of the foundation, or you're using more
foundation
than that,
wall.
Almost 2 feet on
yeah.
the foundation walls. So you're really cutting it pretty close, trying to get out of the car and get around. No room for a workbench, no room really for anything, no trash barrels, nothing in that garage. You could get the two cars in, but that's about it.
Mm.
So that's, by today's standards, that's what we try and look for.
Well, I think you heard a couple of other members of the board.
Yeah.
The other option, you're putting a attic level on the second floor. By extending that somewhat, that would be a perfect work area for Tony to work on a number of different things.
But I'm not sure we can use that attic for anything other than storage. That the new bylaws limit any detached structure within the side yard and rear yard, which this is, even though it's conforming to the 5 feet on either side, it's limited to a single story structure. So as I understood it, I could use it for storage, but we cannot use it for anything other than storage.
Mm.
So you couldn't use it for a workbench, you couldn't use it for any kind of hobby space nowadays.
That was the discussion regarding the roof lines.
That's
and
correct.
Yeah.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, it's pretty strict. If we moved that to be 20 feet off the back and 15 foot in, then we could go to a two-story structure. But in his particular, this we could, there isn't any way to do that in this piece of property.
Okay, I liked Tony's suggestion. We can make this a tandem.
That's right, yeah. If I could just talk to him for just a second, I think it would be worthwhile withdrawing our variance so that we're not prejudiced coming back.
Well, if that's the way you
flexibility so that,
sure.
Yeah, so
yeah.
that you're not struggling with it and it doesn't become an issue and then it doesn't preclude us from coming back at some point in the future should we come up with some other brain idea.
I think that would be fine. So basically what you're asking is to withdraw your variance request.
Correct.
On the whole thing. That would include the garage and that 4x4.
That's correct.
We're calling the step,
yes.
The structure platform. Yeah.
Yes, and we'll work that out.
So we won't work, so there'll be no variance. So basically we're dealing with a special permit tonight in regards to the expansion in the rear and in the front. The kind of shifting the front stairs over now to the right there a bit. Okay, well, that sounds good. David,
so
any questions?
We would have to make a motion to approve the withdrawal.
Yes. Yeah.
And then a second motion on the special permit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Just want to.
That's right.
Compute.
Kind of run it through our minds here a bit.
What's I?
Yeah.
No, I'm just thinking.
Oh, you.
I'm waiting for it to come out.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
John.
You look like you're ready to say something.
Any further questions? No.
I can understand going to a back-to-back car garage. To me, the choice between that
I've
and the other,
that.
Even though you're avoiding the variance,
yeah,
whatever
yeah.
it is, a back-to-back is not as usable, in my view, as the other one, okay?
No.
Particularly in winter weather. You got to have a problem.
Right.
You want to get that front car in that garage. So there's
right.
there's other things.
There are other things, too. No worries.
There's other common sense things that play into this thing that you compare against the variance, okay?
I think also in this particular case, I have not had a chance to discuss this with
him,
but part of the problem with the tandem garage is that you don't really have that much length.
Well, that's the problem. I mean, you're on a lot. You're on a lot that has no space.
That's right. That's
okay, no space.
I think an oversized single car garage would be
and
we'll work that through.
Yeah, that's it. You may end up with
a little bit narrower, but still large enough to get.
Yeah, what I figure out here, it would require 418 square feet,
right.
Would bring you right up to exactly the 25% lot coverage,
right.
And that would be 21. By 19.9 feet, that'd be a pretty good size single car garage with plenty of room for a work, on that, Okay, anyway, the request is to withdraw the variance on that. Any comments on that from board members?
No.
Well, number one, I reopened the public hearing. I'll close that again, John.
Okay.
And, I guess I'll entertain a motion in regards to the request for withdrawing the variance request.
All right, so we'll do a twofold. I'll make a motion that the board approve and accept the withdrawal of the petitioner under case 1601. Of the portion of their application relating to a variance from section 6.3. Isn't that what they'd be looking for, a variance from 6 and 7.3.2?
Let's see, occupy no more than 25% of the required.
So just 6.3. So just
actually,
be
I had it down here written, and when I was going through it, I had page 36 of the bylaws, section 5.5.1F. Occupy not more than 25% of the, that's the required rear yard. That was for the garage. That's for the
right.
garage. But 25% of the lot, yes, 6.3.
Right. So I'm going to make a motion to that the board approve the petitioner's withdrawal of a request for a variance from 6.3 as it relates to the exterior stair / platform and single-story detached two-car garage.
Yes.
Exceeding
the 25% lot
which
coverage.
Which exceeds, the 25% lot coverage,
So
okay,
made.
Thank you.
Second.
A second from John on that. Any comment from board members? If not, all those in favor of the motion? Raise your hand. Let the minutes show that the board approves the request to withdraw the variance from the applicant. And so now what we have before us is a request for a special permit, which will encompass the improvements to the main dwelling, structure, domicile, main house there. That's the improvements to the porch and stairway at the southeasterly corner of the structure, and also the rebuilt foundation and remodeling of the structure with proposed deck at the rear of the domicile.
Right, and yeah. Bear with me, maybe we need some input from Nancy.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't that porch addition include the stairs that we just withdrew?
That what you just withdrew was that little porch.
Okay.
That's associated with the stairs.
Okay. Yeah.
That's the only porch.
Okay. Right.
Yeah. Right. So the special permit relating to the expansion of the front porch would not include that.
That's right.
Okay, good. Good. I want to just make sure we get it right.
Right.
We can do it. Okay, good. All right, I'll make that motion too.
Do you add the garage to that?
I'm sorry?
Do you add the building of the garage to that motion?
To the withdrawal?
You need a permit to build the garage, don't you?
Yes.
A special permit?
Need a relief.
But before the...
They don't need a special permit for the garage.
As long as we stay within the lot coverage, we can do that by right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. As long as it's, the garage are allowed the setbacks that they have shown on the plan, they're allowed that by right. And
the present design's been withdrawn.
Right.
So if they want to build one with a different design that stays within the lot coverage, then they don't need us.
Right. So the special permit will not encompass the garage.
Doesn't like it.
Unless he says you do.
Okay.
All right, so I'll move that the board approve the application for a special permit in case 1601 from, according to 732 of the zoning bylaw,
mm-hmm.
to expand the front porch 6.6 feet by 11.6 feet, and to expand the rear of the structure for a two-story addition
mm-hmm.
on the property at 57 Federal Street, Reading, Mass. With the three, I'm sorry, go ahead.
I was going to say, with the proposed deck.
With the proposed deck, yeah.
With the proposed deck on
deck
that.
On the back of it.
That also is non-conforming. It will be allowed to be 9 feet.
Oh, okay. So.
This would be in the same finding that we're using for 732. Addition plus.
Add a single, I'm missing the rear deck.
The proposed
on the
plot
plan.
All right, I'm looking at the case description.
Okay.
Is it in the application?
Let's see.
I absolutely agree that it's in the plan.
Yeah, it's.
I just want to I want to see where it's
noted.
Requested relief.
Okay, I got the building permit. Let's take a look.
Right here.
Uh-huh.
With a platform and stairs to expand the rear.
That's the front. No,
addition.
that platform and stairs relates to the front porch.
Okay.
Building permit to add a front porch and mirror and deck. It's noted in the building permit review that there's a deck.
Okay.
And
all right. Okay, so I guess what we'll do then in referencing the rear deck. Give me those dimensions again.
Application.
16 by 15?
Correct. Plus,
six by 15 feet? Okay. 6 by 15 feet deck on the rear portion of the property.
Yeah.
Proposed.
exposed addition, proposed addition.
Well, that's what I already, let me restate that. Sorry. Let me restate the motion.
Okay.
To include that so it makes sense in plain English. All right, so I make a motion that the board approve the application for a special permit in accordance with 732 of the zoning bylaw in order to expand the front porch 6.6 by 11.6.
Uh-huh.
And to expand the rear for a two-story addition as well as a 6 by 15 deck.
Yep.
At the rear of the property located at 57 Federal Street, Reading, Massachusetts.
Right.
With the standard three conditions being
foundation permit required. After that's approved, a building permit for the structure itself, and then after that's approved, an occupancy permit. Then as-built plans are prepared.
Yep.
Yep. Okay.
So moved.
Do I have a second on that?
Second.
Second from Cy, John. Yeah. And any further questions from board members?
Did you want to include the...
I think I want to reference the plans.
We want to reference the plans?
I'm going to reference the...
Even though they're going to change a bit, but we can reference them, I think, certainly.
Withdraw your second.
Withdraw the second.
I'll withdraw the second.
All right.
And amend the motion to include...
Motion amended to include reference to the... Let me see, I've got so many drawings in front of me. Let me get that plot plan out.
Set of plan, 15 plans.
I want
to reference the plot plan first.
Yep.
And then we'll get to Nancy's drawings.
Sure.
Let me have that. Thank you. In accordance with the plot plan dated 11/23/15, stamped by John Sullivan, professional engineer of Woburn, Massachusetts, as well as the drawings by Toomey Design, dated 12/1/15, sheets 1 through 15.
Yep. Sure. I think if we just say the relevant drawings, because some of them have the garage in it.
Do you want to exclude the...
Why don't we just say the relevant drawings based on the motion?
Drawings related to the structures being approved in the special permit.
Right. Right.
Only.
That's fine. Yep.
How about 1 through 10?
Is that just 1 through 10?
Yep.
All right, drawings 1 through 10, dated December 1, 2015.
Is that okay, Nancy?
Toomey Design of 23 California Road, Reading, Mass.
Okay.
So moved.
So we have a motion.
I'll second it again.
A second from Cy. And any further discussion from board? If not, we have a motion. All those in favor of that motion, raise your hand. Okay. So let me stamp these for you, Nancy, your plans and a plot plan here, and we will get that written up, filed with the clerk, and then there is a 20-day appeal period. Remember that.
You have it.
Right.
Oh, there it is. See the stamp?
Oh, here it is.
Okay. thank you very much. Yep. Okay, thank you.
Good night.
Yep, good night.
See you Monday.
Be in here somewhere, huh? The plot plan, you would think, in the town's file. There it is.
You said.
Some minutes to go through, so. Okay. That's the agenda. Okay. Everybody's taking some time to read the minutes here. Excuse us. Yeah, we have more business to conduct here. Yeah, so if you don't mind. Nicely. Okay, thank you. Yeah. Certainly. Yeah, that'll be fine. Great, thank you. Yep, and feel free, you can talk out there. Yeah, feel free out there, you can converse. Yep. Okay, the first minutes we have to contend with, I have, is October 15th. And I did have a comment on that one. Let's see, I believe that was a meeting that I was absent on. but yet the minutes say that I opened up the meeting. So I don't know how I could be absent and open it, but I think that's David opened up, Mr. Chianello opened up that meeting, right, David?
I did.
Yes.
Thank you.
You were the one on that. So if we can fix that, Kim, and I believe that's the only comment I had on that meeting. I wasn't here, so.
You were here in spirit, Bob.
Oh, well, thank you. So, other than that, and I did read through it, I didn't see anything that jumped out at me on that, but does anybody else have any comments on the October 15th?
Motion. I wasn't here either, so.
You weren't, so.
Motion to approve the minutes of October 15th, 2015 as amended.
Second.
Second. All those in favor? Okay, thank you. Okay, so we, 15th is approved. And we have November 5th is the next set of meeting. And let's see, did I went through it. I had no comment on that particular one after reading through it. I don't know if anybody else caught anything, but.
Yeah, I did.
Okay.
I know my name is hard to spell. However, to practice, it will ultimately come to you. Up under members present, you got to put an E at the end of my first name.
Ah.
And on, I believe the last page, no, page, the next to the last page.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe two thirds of the way down, got to respell my last name.
Okay.
I didn't find anything else either.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Okay, did you catch both those, Kim?
I did.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anybody else comments on November? Okay, I'd take a motion.
I make a motion to accept the minutes of November 5, 15 minutes as amended.
Second.
Second. All those in favor? Okay, thank you. And we have December 3rd. And I think I was going on that one.
On page two,
yeah,
the correct spelling of Mr. DeRezzo's name is right the first time it's spelled. And then the second two times, it's incorrect.
Okay, see, that's, I had that one. And then, I think as we get into that paragraph on the same page, Kim, on the motion, second sentence, IUB Engineering, on behalf of the owner, 87 Walker Brook Drive, LLC, a variance under section 8.0. IUB Engineering didn't get the variance. The owner is actually,
yeah,
Walker Brook Drive. So I just slipped that in, on behalf of the owner, 87 Walker Brook Drive, LLC.
Okay.
Does that clarify that, I think?
Yep. And
yeah.
IUB at the beginning of that is A-Y-O-U-B, I think.
Is it?
If it's correct in the first sentence
first.
Of the case,
okay.
Then that's the way it's spelled, I think.
Oh, yeah. Right, two different spellings there. So, yep, you're right.
Yeah, the right one is. I don't remember.
Yep. And I would assume the first one is correct, yeah. And I think that is all I had.
Just one more thing, Mr. Chairman. I have on page one, where it begins, Mr. Pedro confirmed the LED. Last sentence is, he said, the standalone sign is an existing non-conforming structure, but would not be adding to the non-confirmatory. I think that means.
Confirmatory.
Yeah, just a spelling thing there.
Non-conformity.
Yeah.
Is what we're looking for, yes. Okay, thank you.
Motion to approve the minutes as amended, December 3rd, 2015.
Second.
Seconded. All those in favor? Okay, thank you. And I think that's pretty much we have on the agenda for business tonight. I did want to add something else, gentlemen. I have some documentation I left with everybody tonight in regards to a, I won't even say pending, right now it's been approved by Mass Housing, a 40B. We have not received the application here in the town. But I did want to give you a copy of the Mass Housing letter and also a copy of the overview of the new Chapter 40Bs information. Now, I understand, I met this afternoon with the assistant town manager, the town manager, and the new town planner, community development director, regarding this. And one thing that Gene pointed out to me, that there is some new 40B regulations as of December 2014. And I told her, I said, I don't think I have, I probably have an older version of them. I said, we'll maybe request those and the town could probably get them for us. But in the meantime, what she did was given an overview of the Chapter 40B. I think it's like 30 pages, the new Chapter 40B one, double-sided, etc. So she just gave the overview on that. And plus the Mass Housing letter given, and it's preliminary approval of the application submitted by the developer for the 40B at the intersection of Lincoln Street and Prescott, the Doucette building. Yeah, Doucette and the Certainly Wood building in there. That they feel will probably be before us this very, very shortly. This might be next month, month after maybe.
Before the
but
spring,
I would just, I, from the way the town talks, it would be sound sooner rather than later.
Imminent.
Yeah, sooner rather than later. We have received notice today that their meeting, the zoning board meeting for January 21st, has been canceled. Since there has been no cases submitted on that. So our next meeting, I believe February 3rd, is it the 3rd? The first Thursday in February, anyway, would be our next meeting. I think it might be the 3rd on that. And until then, feel free to do that. I know the original application on this is down here at Town Hall, so if anybody was interested in coming down and grabbing the original before we get our packets on the 40B, you're certainly welcome to come down and take a look at that. And then I think you could probably get it off of the town website too.
The town website has a specific link for this 40B.
Yes.
And a second 40B that's been proposed.
Yes,
town.
There's another one
link
on
to its own
Lowell Street too.
Information
one, yeah.
Box, if you will.
Another one where?
Lowell Street.
Yeah, Lowell Street.
If you, I believe it's that structure we looked at a few months back in regards to historical, and they were trying to save it, historical house, the Dixon or something house. And it sounds like
it's up the street from there.
It's up the street from there. Oh, it's a different
street.
Location. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
This but first letter on the website is accompanied by the entire application package.
Yes.
It comprises approximately 180 pages.
Yeah.
Of text, so
yeah,
for your reading enjoyment.
And the obviously the selectmen looked at it, and some of the town departments have already looked at it and commented when the applicant came before the selectmen to present it and present his and give his application to Mass Housing. So you can see some of the comments there, and Mass Housing has noted that the developer should work to answer, you might say, or respond to the comments originally submitted by the town in regards to its development. So we're going to be, you know, working that way too. I know the town manager and the assistant town manager, new community development director, were kind of feeling their way around this. I don't think they've gone through a 40B before. They were asking me, and I said, well, we've been through, I think I've sat here and been through four of them maybe, five, depending. Some of them, Beacon Street, Reading Commons, Johnson Woods, and I think there might have been even some another smaller one in there. I know we did the one up on Main Street that was a revamp on that one we discussed a bit. John's been in, sat in on every one I think the town has had. So great resource there.
Six or so.
Yeah, yeah. So.
Yeah, they had a laundry, I mean, you could just see from the Mass Housing approval, there's a laundry list of concerns that were raised by the town that Mass Housing asked the developer to address.
So until it does come in, you know, we certainly, I don't think, want to get into it too deep then on that. Okay, thank you, gentlemen. I would entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved then.
Second.
Second. All those in favor of adjournment? Okay, thank you. And we will see everybody in February.
Well, we don't
hopefully.
Have yeah, we don't have anything on a calendar yet, right?
No, nothing on the calendar yet. Right, right.
But that would be the next open meeting.
So.